And here come the Germans now, led by their skipper, Nobby Hagel. They must surely start favorites this afternoon. They've certainly attracted the most attention from the press with their team problems. And let's now see their lineup. The Germans playing 4-2-4, Leibniz in goal, back four, Kant, Hegel, Schopenhauer and Schelling, front runners Schlegel, Wittgenstein, Nietzsche and Heidegger, and the midfield duo of Beckenbauer and Jaspers. Beckenbauer obviously a bit of a surprise there. And here come the Greeks, led out by their veteran centre-half, Heraclitus. Let's look at their team. As you'd expect, it's a much more defensive lineup. Plato's in goal, Socrates a front-runner there, and Aristotle as sweeper. Aristotle very much the man in form. One surprise is the inclusion of Archimedes. Well, here comes the referee, Kung Fu Tzu, Confucius and his two linesmen, St. Augustine and St. Thomas Aquinas. And as the two skippers come together to shake hands, we're ready for the start of this very exciting final. The referee, Mr. Confucius, checks his sand, and they're off. Nietzsche and Hegel there. Carl Jaspers, number 7 on the outside. Wittgenstein there with him. There's Beckenbauer. Schelling's in there, Heidegger covering. Schopenhauer. And now it's the Greeks, Epicurus, Plotinus number 6. Aristotle. Empedocles of Acragas and Democritus with him. There's Archimedes. Socrates, there he is, Socrates. Socrates there, going through. There's a ball, there's a ball. Well, there may be no score, but there's certainly no lack of excitement here. As you can see, Nietzsche has just been booked for arguing with the referee. He accused Confucius of having no free will, and Confucius, he say, name go in book. Well now, with just over a minute left, replay on Tuesday looks absolutely vital. And there's Archimedes, and I think he's had an idea. Eureka! Archimedes out to Socrates. Socrates back to Archimedes. Archimedes out to Heraclitus. He beats Hegel. Heraclitus, a little flick. Here he comes on the far post. Socrates is there. Socrates, there he is. Socrates has scored. The Greeks are going mad. The Greeks are going mad. Socrates scores. But beautiful cross from Archimedes. The Germans are disputing it. Hegel is arguing that the reality is merely an a priori adjunct of non-naturalistic ethics. Kant, by the categorical imperative, is holding that ontologically exists only in the imagination. And Marx is claiming it was offside. But Confucius lances them with the final whistle. It's all over.